So this right here is Sunsama. It is a powerful application because it blends two worlds, the goal of being slower in your productivity, as well as being able to bring in the stuff that is happening right now. It's like a perfect mix between a planner, a calendar, and a task management app, all baked into one with more of a system behind it. We're going to explore in this video exactly how it works and a little bit more about their more recent features of time boxing. Today's video is kindly brought to you by Sunsama themselves. If you are interested in exploring Sunsama, you can find the link in the description. So I think the best place to start with this app is giving you an idea of how it works in a little bit more detail. So let's get started with the basic navigation around Sunsama. And you'll notice that it looks slightly different. It's a lot calmer in its design. There's a little bit more gray, more relaxing than maybe some of the other solutions out there. So if you're looking for something that feels a little bit calmer to use, then this could be something that brings that aesthetic in. So you can organize your main area in a few different ways. So if I just hide this, you can go over here and change it to a board, or you can move to a calendar view. This is important because some people just like to be able to see tasks that they have in a board view. Others like to be able to see the calendar view, which gives you more of a projection of what's on the day. Now, the great thing is here, say today, I could press A and I could start adding tasks. Now, in this case, I might add a few tasks I have to do today. Each task that you add allocates it to a particular suggested folder and also adds it to a time allocation. In this case, if I go ahead and add that, it's going to add all those details in for me. Okay, so as you can see here, I've started to add a few items to my list. And what it's automatically done is used a time boxing technique to automatically plan where these tasks should go based on what you have in your system and set up. So as you can see, it's kind of correlated a few of them to a few different areas. For example, it's put this film Sunsama video around this sort of time because I've got the most runway compared to the other correlated tasks. So you can go ahead and move them around. For example, if I wanted to go on a walk near the end of the day, I could shuffle that around. But what's nice is it recalibrates it to the calendar. And if there's something you want to be a little bit more specific on, you can pin this to the calendar here, which makes it more of a fixed time that things need to work around. So the idea here is you've got a little bit more flexibility, but you also have the structure of planning around. Now, you may have noticed I've got small gaps in my calendar between each of the tasks that I'm doing. Now, that's because if you go over to the settings area, which is up here, and you go to settings, then you can go into the time boxing area and add a few different things. You can actually visualize and project it onto your calendar with the actual times, but you can also hide time for completed tasks on your calendar. But there is one area that I went to particular is the breathing room between the tasks that you have. So you can allocate this to no time, 5 minutes to all the way to 15 minutes. And this is a great way to avoid running into the next task without any preparation or just mental break. So that's something to include when looking at getting started with each of your tasks. Now, as you can see, Sunsama looks a lot different, particularly in the features of this application. So I wanted to sort of point towards some of the things that make it slightly different. So over here, you can see that there's a daily rituals area. And this is where it's much more unique than other applications, because what you can do is if you just chucked all of those tasks in for the day, what you can do is fill your day up with work and shut down for the day at the end of the day. So in this case, if I want to shut down for the day, that is currently projected around 6 p.m. But let's say hypothetically, I wanted to bring that to 3:30. And what I'm going to do here is it's going to be able to move that here. And I can even move it a little bit closer around here. And you can see that these type of things come up, which is an indication you might not be able to get that work done today. So if I hypothetically had that shut down at 2:45 today, you can see that it's giving me an unrealistic workload. Now, this is what makes it slightly different, is it's indicating to me that you've overloaded yourself for today based on what your criteria of overloaded is. Now, a lot of people might like this because it's the type of thing that gets them to think about the prioritization of work versus actually you overloading and just dumping a million different things on your to-do list. So as you can see here, I can defer work to tomorrow, and it's automatically taken that piece of work that's not going to get completed and move it out. And it's probably done that because I've got a fixed thing in my calendar here. So I can do that with other stuff as well. Say bins, you can have stuff that's personal as well. And you can really start to bump back things even all the way to next week too. So if I go to my day, I can now see, okay, this day looks a little bit more approachable. I believe I can fit that into the window of time I'm working with. I can see up here, I can add additional time. I can see time work remaining, and I can press looks good. Now, this is quite a nice little feature if you're somebody that works in a team, or you just like to have that accountability aspect. Maybe it is just to see what you've done for the day, but you can post it directly to Slack and to Microsoft Teams. Now, why would you do that? Well, number one, it's a good way for you and your team to work out what you've worked on during the day. So if a bunch of you have got Sunsama, and then you can post quickly, automatically, without worrying, maybe somebody will be able to reply and comment, say, I can help you with that tomorrow, etc. Or you can actually use this as self-reflection. So in this case, you can actually use the obstacles in my way section to start writing about what was tricky. So I could say, I found planning the conference hard, for example. Now, as you can see, I can go ahead and press get started, and it's automatically helping me to structure the day. Now my daily planning is done, I can go and do a daily shutdown if I want to. So daily shutdown is effective because if you got a bit of work today done, you can see what you did, and then you can see what you didn't get to. Now, the objective of this is also a bit of a reflective exercise. It's this concept of talking about, it's a bit like a journaling how your work went. So you can say, how was today? Did you have any concern? What am I grateful for? You can include any activities that were highlights, and you can even bring in stuff. So I can include this bike ride with my little boy, and I could, you know, include other, you know, meetings that were notable and things like that. But it's a great way to track how successful you felt across that day. And then you can publish that. Now, you can save that entry to your account, but you can also publish that to Slack or Microsoft Teams. Some people probably won't like that. So I can go ahead and send it to somebody specifically, or I could copy the markdown or copy the link to this. And you can also see that it has posted it to my private daily highlights so that I can see a reflection of that. I can also get it to send to my email address. I can modify the prompts if I want, and I can see who and what shows up. Now, why would you want that? Well, I tend to do this every single week. I sit down with myself and I just say, what have I overloaded myself on this week? What are my priorities? And how can I do things better? At least I think it's an exercise that I quite like to give me a little bit of reflection time. So you can go to the daily highlights area to see exactly all of the different entries that you've had. You can edit today's entry, you can add comments, and it's a great way to see and reflect on what's happened in the past. So the next area that's important is weekly objectives. Now, I quite like the objectives concept. It's almost like a zoom out. The zoom out is very, very important when it comes to enhancing how you do things as an individual. Being able to not focus on a million things is going to be a big game changer in the world of AI, because it's more about decision making and creativity than what you actually do by the quantity amount. So in this case, I might put, say, like launch product, I don't know. So what I can do when I click into a weekly objective is allocate time automatically to a certain thing. So I can say, got 50 minutes here, 30 minutes this day, etc. And what I'm doing here is I'm not just deciding when I'm gonna focus on this type of thing, but I'm actually allocating it to my calendar. So if I allocate it to work and I go back in to this week, I can also reflect as well, like I did with there. If I go to next week, I can see that all of these have the objective concept here, which is really, really helpful. So it's aligning you with an objective. And then I can reflect on my week as well, which is another useful activity. In this case, I can do that with my time as well spent, as well as what I focused on. Now, you're probably wondering, okay, Francesco, how can I use this to enhance my focus at work as well? So there is a feature, if I had this as my next task, where I can do all the regular stuff I can in a typical task management app, like add due dates, add tasks, add comments. But there's this feature here where it's almost like a window, and I can start the task and I can add notes below. This is a great way to implement systems like Pomodoro, which you can click up here and do certain cycles of it during the day. But you get this window into your day, which is, I am focusing on this task and this task alone. I can start a timer on it, and I can see where I plan in work. Now, this is really an effective technique. It's known as monotasking. I really think it's one of the best ways to actively focus on a task, and I think it could be a great way to use it in this particular feature. I can also go to the today view to zoom into today and really get those uninterrupted distractions here. Now, you're probably wondering, what are these down the side? Well, Sunsama has something called a unified inbox. These are becoming much more common, but they're a great way to bring in tasks from other apps. So the reason why you would do that is because you're getting bombarded by a lot of different applications across your day. And being able to see them all in one place to sort and process where they go is very important. For example, if you're using a project management app and somebody else is using a to-do list app and they're sending you different things, or your team uses one that you don't feel as you're in control in, which is totally fine, then you can bring that work in and you can even connect up things like Gmail. So here's to-do list, for example. You can use these to-do list tasks to get things done. You can also set up automations up here, which is a helpful way to tick things off in your to-do list at the same time as ticking it off in your Sunsama. So if your team uses to-do list, whether they use Notion or whether you just want to see your weekly objectives or backlogged items that you need to get done, you can see it all here and search for it as well. And there are a few other different abilities down here. You can connect up with the likes of GitHub, Outlook, Linear, and many more. So the final area I want to talk about is actually quite extensively the settings area. Now, the reason I want to talk about the settings area is because there's some great ways to set up things that particularly set up to your needs. For example, if you're somebody that just wants to work 2 hours a day, maybe you are free, or maybe you want to work 16 hours in a day, whatever it may be, you can select what's right for you. In this case, I'm going to be 2 hours, and it's going to start to correlate your work based on a system. For example, there's 1.5 hours left. I'm obviously encroaching on how much is actual and planned. So I can help to understand why, and potentially I may be overloaded. Red will signify that you need to change things, and it'll help you to better plan and not take yourself or be overwhelming to some extent. There's also great setups here for the ritualing. For example, if you want to have that ritual to come up every single day at 8:30, or you don't want an encouragement message or a custom message, you can set that up. You can also have automated weekly planning, so it starts to bring in and automatically set up your day for you, which Sunsama can do with the time boxing feature. But what I would say around the whole concept of the settings area is the more you spend time in something like this, the better quality your setup is going to be. And that is really a good example of how AI is working in a moment. Like, there are the AI features in here that allow you to do channel recommendations, AI summaries of certain things that you bring in, like daily highlights. But the key is spending time in crafting how you would like to see your day individually, especially with the integrations, which are quite extensive down here, and how you want them to react to how you're working and your style of work. Sunsama is one of these applications that blends itself really well between being the focus app, the planner app, and managing your calendar. It does stuff slightly different to other people on the market, and it's really a good quality, well put together tool. I actually used Sunsama for about 2 or 3 years, and I think it definitely was a lot more approachable in how you manage things, because what it does is help you to bring in stuff from other platforms, like say your team's using ClickUp, but also allows you to be a bit more mindful about what you're focusing on in the day, not overloading yourself to some extent. So hopefully I gave you a good guide to Sunsama. You can find it linked below if you're interested, and I look forward to helping you with more software and tools, helping you find them, save on them, and I'm sure in the future I'll see you to help you find another one very soon. Cheerio for now, folks, and check out Sunsama in the link in the description. Bye-bye.